Let's get to the news. President Biden hosted a reception at the White House today to celebrate Hanukkah, and although his speech was just supposed to be one night, it magically lasted for 8. President Biden traveled to Philadelphia today and spoke at an event with firefighters. Biden can relate to firefighters because he's also sliding down the poles. You smell smoke! President Biden attended a Shiva on Saturday for legendary TV producer Norman Lear. Unable to attend, Archie Bunker and Meathead. According to a new poll, New York Mayor Eric Adams has the lowest approval rating ever recorded for a New York City mayor. In fairness, that's only 5 points lower than the highest approval rating ever recorded for a New York City mayor. We hate our mayors. It's a very small window. President Biden traveled last week to Las Vegas because one way or another, he's getting that money for Ukraine. A New York man who is running for George Santos' old congressional seat was convicted last week for participating in the Capitol attack. Okay, can we just put this congressional seat in jail? I think that would just make it easier at this point. The donut chain Krispy Kreme last week opened its first store in France at long last, a place to get a decent pastry in Paris.
What is this? That is not how you spell crispy? This is an abomination of taste and spelling.
And finally, the rock bands Def Leppard and Journey last week announced they're going on tour together, and you have not seen those bands until you've seen them on the iPad of the guy in front of you. According to the latest numbers, President Biden has visited New York City 11 times since taking office. That's nothing. Trump's been here 11 times in the last month. Gets one of those little sketches done every time he's here.
He's like, well, can I get one in roller skates?
During an event yesterday in Philadelphia, President Biden appeared to mistakenly refer to the Marine One presidential helicopter as, quote, Air Force Helicopter One. You know what? I don't even think that's a gaffe. I think once you get to a certain age, you don't care what stuff is called anymore. It's the same reason your dad calls Yellowstone Yellow Ranch. He doesn't care. He just gets as close as he can and then goes, you know what the hell I mean. The one with Beth Dutton. Oh, he remembers her name. Harvard University announced today that President Claudine Gay will stay in her post following criticism of her testimony at a congressional hearing on campus anti-Semitism. Because if anyone's been punished enough, it's someone in Massachusetts named President Gay. That was submitted by our resident masshole, Mike Scollins. Ukrainian President Zelensky met today with House Speaker Mike Johnson before going to the White House to speak with President Biden, because in America, it's customary to go ask dad when mom says no. According to a new report, former President Trump contacted. Why did you spell it the right way? According to a new report, former President Trump reached out to an employee of Mar-a-Lago who witnessed multiple incidents of his handling of classified documents and offered the worker legal representation and free tickets to an upcoming golf tournament. Man, only Trump is lazy enough to bribe a witness with stuff he just has lying around.
We gotta shut this guy up, send over some golf tickets, and let's see, Rudy? Should we?
Jury selection began yesterday in the Georgia election workers' defamation case against Rudy Giuliani. Where are you going to find a jury of his peers? Arkham Asylum? New York City Mayor Eric Adams spoke today at a multi-faith gathering. The only faith not represented was faith in Eric Adams. According to a new poll, 1 in 5 registered voters said they would be open to supporting presidential hopeful Robert F. Kennedy Jr. And if Kennedy can just talk to some of those people, he could get it to 1 in 10. Math joke. According to the latest numbers from AAA, more than 115 million people will travel more than 50 miles from their homes during the holidays, unless a miracle happens and one of your kids gets COVID. Oh, my God. I got good news. Netflix yesterday announced it will air the Netflix Slam, which is its first ever live tennis match, and not, as I thought, a less romantic version of Netflix and Chill. Very good one that you're not going to forget soon. According to new research, teenage girls are more likely to use Instagram than teenage boys. Said teenage boys, depends on what you mean by use. And finally, the Ritz Paris recently found a guest's missing $800,000 ring in the bag of a vacuum cleaner, which is also how Motel 6 recently found a guest's missing kid. That is way too young a kid. That joke does not work on that kid. Eight. Like, that kid's never okay again. Yeah, they found him, but that kid's scarred for life. President Biden yesterday announced an additional $200 million in funds for Ukraine, which is great, but it's not enough money to fight a war. It's barely enough money to make a movie about a war. That's right, Ukrainian President Zelensky spoke with lawmakers yesterday on Capitol Hill and said, keep your weapons, just give me this guy. President Biden has reportedly told confidants that he feels guilty about his son Hunter's legal issues and feels that Hunter wouldn't be facing criminal prosecutions if he had not run for president in 2020. Hell, with his resume, Hunter would probably be looking at a spot in Trump's cabinet.
Secretary of Parties.
Former President Trump is selling pieces of the suit he wore during his mugshot, or for 10 bucks, you can just go to a Joseph A. Bank and get the whole thing. That's right, former President Trump is selling pieces of the suit he wore during his mugshot, you know, like billionaires do. You think Rupert Murdoch would sell you his suit? If he thought you wanted his suit, he would burn it in front of you. There you go, mate. Take all the ashes you want. CNN hosted a town hall event last night in Iowa with Florida Governor Ron DeSantis. It's a rare example of a sentence in which Iowa is the most interesting word. The FBI arrested an internet pornography personality last week for allegedly participating in the attack on the Capitol. He was the one who went in the rear entrance. I'm sorry. I don't know what happened. Let me try again. I apologize. The FBI arrested an internet pornography personality last week for allegedly participating in the attack on the Capitol. Well, you didn't get Mike Pence, but at least one guy was hung. We fixed it. According to a new survey, 40% of millennials think that couples should talk about finances before a relationship gets serious. Said one millennial couple, we're good. In an effort to stop Smith & Wesson from manufacturing assault rifles, a group of Catholic nuns recently filed a lawsuit against the gun maker, but only because they prefer a more traditional assault weapon. And finally, the makers of Doritos have announced a partnership with the flavor company Empirical to offer a nacho cheese-flavored alcohol. It's a perfect way to celebrate when Maury says you're not the father. Hunter Biden spoke outside the U.S. Capitol yesterday and criticized Republicans for ridiculing his struggle with addiction. Unfortunately, when it comes to Hunter Biden, Republicans are also struggling with addiction. That's right. Hunter Biden spoke to reporters yesterday and said that his father was, quote, not financially involved in any of his business ventures. Well, I believe that. He seems like the kind of dad who wouldn't even get involved in your lemonade stand when you were a kid. You want to sell lemonade, do you? I guess you better get busy planting a lemon tree. At a rally last night in Iowa, former President Trump said that he feels mentally sharper now than he was 20 years ago and added he is a, quote, much better golfer than he was 10 or 15 years ago. Well, that's what 4 years of uninterrupted practice will do for you. A new poll now shows former President Trump leading President Biden in all 7 swing states that will decide the 2024 election, which brings us to our new segment. Seth tries to remember where he put his passport. Is it my desk drawer? No, I took it out of my desk drawer because of the kids. Maybe in my bag? Damn it. You know what? I'm just going to call Alexi after show.
This has been Seth Tries to Remember Where He Put His Passport.
Russian President Vladimir Putin held his annual end-of-year news conference today and answered questions for more than 4 hours. Important questions such as, why are you so handsome and please be our president forever? Today was former House Speaker Kevin McCarthy's last day at the Capitol before he resigns at the end of the year from Congress. There was a going-away party for him, but he wasn't invited. Boston Mayor Michelle Wu is facing criticism for holding a holiday party specifically for non-white members of city council. Said Wu, sorry if for once I wanted the food to be good. According to the latest numbers, North Dakota has the lowest divorce rate in the country at less than 1%, which is ironic since it's one of the only states that's legally separated from its partner. Map comedy. A family aboard their houseboat in Florida recently found a snake that was hiding in a sock drawer, though honestly, on a houseboat in Florida, I would have been more surprised if they had found socks. I love that joke so much. True story. Did it yesterday. Stumbled on it a little bit. Said to Baze, I said, you know what, Baze? Let's cut it. Let's put it in tomorrow. Get the home run it deserves. Said it perfectly. Exact same result. And finally, Apple is reportedly planning to overhaul its lineup of iPads to make it, quote, less confusing for consumers. In the meantime, owners of an iPad are being asked to direct any tech questions they may have to the nearest toddler.